Subscribe to Film Companion for your film fix. Hit the bell icon so you never miss an update.
Hello, everybody, and thank you for joining me from across Mumbai and Chennai. Hello, and who would have thunk we would do Let's Talk Movies like this? But it is what it is.
It is what it is. Indeed. I think
extraordinary times.
Extraordinary times. Absolutely. Absolutely. I just think the world as we knew it is over.
Anu, I'm panicking enough as it is. So please don't say things like that because it just sends a shiver down my spine and makes
me feel like somebody broke
an egg on my head.
No. It's a good thing. It's a good thing because we were clearly we needed to stop. At the end of this gloom and doom and darkness and disease, there will be. I'm the great optimist, and I always believe there will be a happy ending. Always. That's what Bollywood has taught me. There's always a happy ending.
I sure hope so. I just, I had to go out today to like buy some essentials. I was out of like some veggies and things. So I went out in the morning and like maintained distance and like bought some stuff and quickly came back and showered. But it's a ghost town out there. There are no people, no cars, no dogs, like nothing. It's quite unnerving to see Mumbai right now.
Yeah. I'm sure it's the same in Chennai, Badi. What's happening there?
Yeah, there's practically nobody on the roads. They're talking about a clampdown, lockdown. I think people are a little unsure about these terms because people understand good old words like curfew, which have been in use for a long time, but things like lockdown are a little, I don't think people quite get them. So I don't know what's going to happen. 6 p.m. today is when it's all supposed to begin.
Okay. Well, let's do some useful things. See, all we can do is try and help. And I guess as people who critique content, all we can do is help by telling people what to watch, how to get happy. We ran a lovely a playlist by Varun Grover on Film Companion recently, where he's just giving you songs to lift your spirits, and that's fabulous. Tell me what you guys are watching.
I finally watched Marriage Story. I should be very ashamed that it's taken me this long, but I finally sat down and I watched it because, somehow it happens when something is just everybody's talking about it. You kind of like, I'll watch it in my own time. But this was the time I finally watched it. And it reminded me that how before flu season, it was Adam Driver season and how good a time it used to be just until a few weeks ago. Remember, it was when it was Adam Driver season. Every few weeks we had Adam Driver in something new.
Absolutely. I have to tell you that my mother, who's a Netflix addict, one day called me in the morning and she said, "Maine to bada shor suna tha is Marriage Story ka, but kuch samajh nahi aaya, ladte hi rehte hain dono." I was like, okay, that's one perspective. But I loved it.
But your mother is the like love story champion.
Yeah.
She, I would imagine, would have loved the film.
No. She's not. She wants the happy ending. It's in the genes. Baddie, what are you watching?
I'm watching. I long ago made a playlist of like 70s and 80s films from Hindi, Malayalam, Tamil, Telugu, and all that, which is like kind of important. But it's one of those playlists that kept growing, but never really. You keep adding movies to that list, but it never really get the time to watch. So I'm kind of unearthing those and trying to watch some of those just kind of, because they're all kind of available on YouTube. And then I'm watching this TV show called This Is Us, which is this kind of, it's an NBC show that came highly recommended. So I'm about 2 or 3 episodes down. And it's kind of okay, I guess. So I don't know if I'm going to stick with it, but I think I'll give it about 3 or 4 more episodes before I decide.
God, you're very, you commit to that much in a so-so episode thing.
No, I always, I'm incapable of, even if it's the worst film, I cannot like get up and go. I need to like know, like I gave it my, I just stay till the end and then I can curse it. So.
That's commitment for you guys. Rahul, what about you?
I've been catching up again on a lot of Netflix stuff, a lot of stuff I miss. So I'm a big true crime fan. So I've been going back to all the new documentary series that they've been making. So I watched Confession Killer, which was pretty good. I'm watching an Icelandic series called Valhalla Murders, which is really gripping. And, you know, that whole isolation thing really sets in when you're watching like a, you know, either a Norwegian or a Finnish or an Icelandic detective drama and all. So it's, yeah, so I mean, I also rewatched Virus yesterday after a while, which was, yeah, it's just uncanny. Obviously, we didn't have context enough when I watched it last year, but, you know, now it's just hitting all the more harder. And I've been recommending it to a lot of my friends who are not very aware of, you know, that there was a film like that made and Kerala went through that 2 years ago.
Yeah.
So yeah, we've been pretty busy and also I've been writing about a lot of web shows, which is regular programming in general.
Speaking of web shows, I finally watched the second season of You, Rahul. Tumne dekha hai second season?
Yeah, yeah. I finished it as soon as it came out. I was a big fan of the first season. So.
Yeah, I finally got around to watching that second season. And again, that show is very interesting because it's that whole debate again, right? When the protagonist is a bad guy, when he's a killer, when he's a murderer, how do you sympathize with the protagonist and things like that? And how do you turn this person into a larger than life figure? And I think season two really kind of answers that because season two goes into his psyche a whole lot more than it did in the first season. We find out his backstory and stuff. So that's a recommendation right there for anyone who's watching. Season one is better than season two, but season two is still very, very good. Especially there's that amnesia episode is just really good. When he forgets what happened. Superb, superb. And also another recommendation, music-wise, Baddy just mentioned This Is Us. The composer who makes music for This Is Us, Siddharth Khosla. He's got a band called Goldspot. And Goldspot was the original Prateek Kuhar. You know, Prateek Kuhar is so famous, like Barack Obama's listening to his music. And for good reason, like he makes really good music. But Goldspot, if you listen to their original music, like Rewind, which was like, you know, there was a couple of songs when the Hudson Overflows used in How I Met Your Mother. And that's like that really soulful good stuff. So that music is Goldspot. The band's called Goldspot by Siddharth Khosla, who makes music for This Is Us. So that's another recommendation for anyone who's looking to find some new music.
Anu, what are you watching?
You know, I'm actually working on a book project and I'm going back to see a lot of the films that I love. So it's been fun. It's actually kind of interesting how your gaze changes because you're at a different place in your life and what you love and what you respond to. And some are still as, you know, they still exert the same grip and some just, you're like, what was I thinking? But it's fun. I can't really go into details right now because it's too early in it. But you know that's it's keeping me sane. I've just discovered that the way to do this is to have a routine and to just stick to it. You know, you cannot tell yourself that this is some sort of time off,
vacation.
Yeah, it's no, not because that's... yeah, buddy.
No. I was just saying that, you know, I'm unable to, like, you know, because of the nature of our jobs, I guess, you know, I'm like, all these people are saying, oh, I don't know what to do at home and stuff like that. I'm not seeing that at all because there's just so much to do.
Yeah.
So much to watch and so much to write about and, you know.
Yeah. And I'm so grateful that we have jobs that can continue at a time like this, you know. I mean, think of all the people who can't do what they do from home. It must be, you know, it's just so difficult. It's so funny. My routine is I wake up at 6 a.m. and I'm still doing that. And my husband's like, are you stupid? The whole world is on lockdown. Why are you waking up at 6 a.m.? I was like, if I don't do it, I'll go crazy. So I have to wake up at 6 a.m.
Same, 6:30 every morning. Like I have to. Because if I allow it to happen once, that I'm sleeping until like 8:30, 9 a.m., then it's just going to become a thing and that's a slippery slope, my friend.
Yeah, absolutely. Okay, guys, let's end with one recommendation each. What should people out there watch?
There is a Pakistani movie on Netflix called Cake, which is quite amazing. Because I've been talking to a lot of people on my Instagram and saying, recommend me films. And that recommendation came from a lot of people. And I watched it today. And it's really amazing. It's like, imagine like a Kapoor and Sons, but Pakistan. And it's mostly like it's about daughters and their aging parents. And it's a beautiful film. So Cake is my recommendation.
Cake, like K-I-C-K, cake.
Cake, like what?
Oh, cake. What, right, what, of course, I've heard of Cake. Yeah, of course. It got really good reviews. I remember that film.
Yeah. I watched it today. It's super. Very good.
Nice. Guys?
For me, there's this Indian film called Rakosh. It's new on Netflix. It's like a couple of months old. It's basically India's first. I mean, I don't know if it is actually India's first, but it's like a rare film that shot from the point of view of the protagonist. The whole film, like 2 hours of it, is like shot like from a point of view. It's like a first person film, and it stars Sanjay Mishra in it. And so not a lot of people know about it, but it's based mostly in an asylum. So I think it's very interesting. Like the film didn't come together totally for me, but I love risky films, and you know the way they've experimented with the craft. And as a student when I was in college, I always used to think of, you know, why is nobody shooting a film, say, from a point of view of a mosquito or a person or like a dog or something like that. So this film comes close to that, which was very interesting to see. I quite enjoyed it.
Nice.
So that's my
Paddy.
I'm going to go with this recent Malayalam movie that came out on Amazon called Ayyappanam Kosham with Prithviraj and Bijuman. I think I don't want to say too much about it. It's a long movie, very, very nicely done. It's one of those relationship films that Malayalam cinema does so well. And I'm just going to, that's one thing. The other thing is I'm going to ask people who have time on their hands to allow themselves to accidentally discover stuff. Because one thing is we are so rigidly controlled about what we watch because our time is restrained that we say, okay, I've got to watch all this. I've got to check this off my list. This is what people are saying great things about. So sometimes even if it's just songs, you know, sometimes you just click on a random song and then YouTube throws up these recommendations and then, you know, you just go on this song and then suddenly there's this song you haven't heard in 10 years and it just bursts on you. And I think, you know, that accidental discovery sometimes is really nice because otherwise our lives are so rigidly controlled. So.
No, I agree. I'll go with a Malayalam recommendation as well. Maya Nadhi, you know, speaking of virus and Ashik Abu, his sort of reimagining of Breathless. But the music was just so beautiful. I'm only reading the subtitling of the lyrics, but I've discovered all the cinema beyond Hindi cinema so late. And I'm so regretful of that because there's such great movies out there. And you're absolutely right, Baddy. I would tell everyone, just go and find a language that you don't speak and watch that film. It's exactly what Bong Joon-ho said. Just get over those subtitles, those little, what did he say? How many inch subtitles? You have a whole world. Yeah, you have a whole world out there. So thank you guys and just hang in there and we'll do this again soon.
All right.
Bye-bye, everyone. Take care.
Lots of love. Bye.
Bye. See you. Bye.